Penguin Random House Audio presents Flip Thinking, The Life-Changing Art of Turning Problems into Opportunities by Berthold Gunster. Read for you by Boris Hiestand.
Yes, but... Imagine this. You've got a great idea, and all you hear are the yes buts. Yes, but that's been tried before and it didn't work. Yes, but shouldn't we just let it sit for a while? Yes, but what if it doesn't work? All those yes buts make you feel that every attempt at innovation will be buried in a swampy morass of seemingly sensible objections. And that's exactly how it works. Yes, but thinking takes a closed attitude to life, throwing up restrictions and threats like dragons blocking your path. However worthwhile an idea or argument might be, it's met with rigidity, which leads to stagnation. There's another way, the yes and attitude. This open-minded perspective emphasizes what can be done, appreciating possibilities. With this attitude, we see past the dragons to the path forward. The result? Creativity and innovation. This book is about the transition from a yes but to a yes and way of living, from thinking in terms of problems to thinking in terms of opportunities. When we approach a problem with a yes and mindset, novel solutions can sometimes be surprisingly easy to discover. Looking at a problem from a new angle, even just a quarter turn, can lead to a big insight with so little effort. We don't have to fight our problems. We can transform them into opportunities. We can make them our allies. The art of turning problems into opportunities can be learned. It's a type of psychological jiu-jitsu, a technique that I call flip thinking, or omdenken in my native Dutch. Flip thinking not only leads to a solution to an existing problem, but, unexpectedly and surprisingly, it can open completely new vistas of possibility. As a caterpillar morphs into a butterfly, a problem is flip thought into a beautiful new reality. This leads to a surprising paradox. The more problems we confront, the better. At its core, flip thinking can improve your life, paradoxically enough, not by avoiding your problems, nor denying them by emphasizing only the good, like a Pollyanna, but by embracing problems, recognizing and accepting pain, loss, and want. Flip thinking always starts with acknowledging reality. A pessimist is completely indifferent to how much water there is in the glass. He'll still just moan that he'll have to do the dishes again. Why not enjoy the glass of water instead? I started the concept of flip thinking in the Netherlands, where I live, in 1997. Since then, my team of actors and trainers and I have put on more than 10,000 theatrical, entertaining and educational workshops on the principles of flip thinking for altogether more than 1 million people. Besides performances in the Netherlands, a British-American team of actors and trainers perform flip thinking sessions in Spain, Singapore, Britain, Germany and France. In total, I have written 12 books about the principle of flip thinking, all of them bestsellers. In the Netherlands alone, they have sold more than 1.3 million copies. Bear in mind, we have a population of only 17.4 million people. These books have been translated into Italian, Portuguese, Danish, German, and, as you are hearing right now, English. The story of flip thinking doesn't end there. It develops, grows, and matures. And I'm proud that you, dear listener, are a part of this journey. Hopefully, you'll enjoy this audiobook. Hopefully, you'll take much away from it. Above all, I hope you'll come away from listening to it with the understanding that problems are nothing more and nothing less than frustration that hasn't found its form yet. Frustration that can be enjoyed once it is flipped and transformed into a new, desirable, sparkling reality. Berthold Gunster. Put this audiobook on your bedside table. A few thoughts on how to listen to this audiobook. Firstly, I once read that around 64% of people regularly read before going to sleep, that the average reading time is 10 minutes, and the average reading pace is around 300 words per minute. This may not be true for every reader, but with these averages in mind, I divided this audiobook into chapters of around 3,000 words each, so you can fit in a chapter each night before bed. If you're listening, the same applies. Each chapter will come in at approximately 20 minutes. Secondly, the audiobook is not a novel. It's non-fiction. It describes thoughts, approaches, and hopefully inspiring examples of flip thinking. However, there's no such thing as the theory of flip thinking that I could set out from A to Z in a logical, straightforward instruction. Explaining to someone how to flip think without letting them try it for themselves can perhaps be best compared to trying to give someone a tour of your house without being able to take them inside. By looking at it from the outside, perhaps through a window or the letterbox, or going around to a side door, or even peering down the chimney, you see something different each time, and along the way, you possibly have the nagging feeling that you're missing the full experience. So I encourage you to not just take my word for it, but to step inside the house, get stuck in, and apply flip thinking to your own life in order to really get a feel for it. Thirdly, learning takes place on multiple levels. Some is conscious, but much is unconscious. We listen to something, dream about it, talk about it with someone the next day, and then often intuitively apply some insight gained, realizing only later that we have done so. This is another reason that I recommend listening at your leisure, bit by bit. Step by step, listening to a chapter each day, you'll give your mind time to absorb and delight in the discoveries. You may also want to re-listen to some of the chapters at some point. Fourthly, pay no attention to the previous thoughts. Listen to the book however you want, or maybe not at all. Yes, but thinking of what should be but isn't. Yes, and seeing what's there and what you could do with it. Flip thinking. A pessimist sees the difficulty in every opportunity. An optimist sees the opportunity in every difficulty. Before we get started, let me tell you a bit more about my background. I trained as a theater director with a specialism in improvisation, or improv as it's commonly known. This background laid the foundation for my flip thinking philosophy. What are the golden rules of improv? Two simple things. To accept reality as it is, and to do something with it. Imagine an improv scene where one actor is a dentist and the other one is a patient. Would there be a scene where the patient did not present a problem? Well, it would be a dull scene. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm fine.
All right, see you next year.
Bye.
Bye. Improv, like all good drama, revolves around a problem. So what do improv actors learn? They learn to embrace, or even better, love problems and what can be created out of them. Use problems as the jumping-off point. When I started working as a theater director, I didn't follow the usual path. For more than 10 years, I created theater plays with and about people who experienced setbacks in life. People who lived in underserved neighborhoods in the city of Utrecht, who faced poverty, unemployment, and other social problems. I also worked with runaway kids, homeless people, and individuals dealing with addiction to drugs or alcohol. I created theater with these people not only in the Netherlands, but also in Ukraine, Spain, Scotland, Germany, Poland, Belgium, and the USA. In Chicago, I initiated a project with homeless people called Not Your Mama's Bus Tour. During this theatrical bus tour, people who were homeless or formerly homeless showed the audience a glimpse of the city through the eyes of the homeless. During all these theater projects as a director, I had to learn one important thing. the people I worked with were not trained as professional actors. Though many of them had undisputed natural theatrical skills, I was forced to work within a lot of limitations. So what did I have to do? I had to learn to work like an improv actor, accept reality as it is, see and accept the limitations of my...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.